we are burning in Hutman Valley today. We have two burn units that we've made here. We have Summer's Mountain today that we'll be doing. That's a total of 425 acres. So we are standing right here with our drone. Right now, all of our firefighters are up the mountain, up here at DP3, drop point 3. They have just started this test fire to make sure that we are good with burning. It's burning as expected. All of our conditions are holding. Once they have burned down these ridges here, making it safe for us, we will then be launching our drone, coming in and starting to ignite this first line at F. And each one of these is our plan of how we want to do ignitions with the drone, lighting each one of these ridge lines. This way we don't have to have firefighters in here at all. It's much safer and it'll actually be a much faster and efficient burn all over today.
It's interesting today in the Allegheny Highlands where we are. We have, on the radio, you can hear a helicopter. So that's a burn called New Road Run, and that's 5,000 acres that they're burning today. We can't do that in the drone. The drone can't fly that far away. So the drone really has applications in the 100 to 5 and 600 acre burn. This is the perfect drone unit because we can fly directly to it. We can see the drone the whole time. The differences between the drone is that the drone, its operating daily operating costs are very, very low. The daily operating cost of a helicopter can range in the, $5,000 to $10,000 per day. So we can spend, a tenth of that on this burn unit with the drone. But the biggest thing that I think about that's helpful for the drone is it gets people out of the helicopter and puts them on the ground. So we eliminate the human risk.
A very common way that you would have burned forests before is actually using your ridge lines of your mountains, and you would have firefighters walk on the top of those ridge lines and carry fire down with them all the way through the unit. It actually does work really well. It's something in some units that we will still use, but unfortunately you do have a risk of there could be holes. You could have wasps. You could have a cliff. We know our units very, very well, but in a lot of cases, especially now that we do have access to a drone with our partners who help us a lot, that it's just not necessary to even put people inside. It's much safer and efficient that we can bring up this drone and let it go fly exactly where we want it to go. You don't have firefighters get lost because they read their compass wrong. You don't have them getting hung up on maybe a riverbed or a mud patch or a hole that they weren't expecting there or didn't see. It's just safer and faster that you program exactly what you need. It does exactly that. You don't have human error. You don't have people slowing down, that we can progress much quicker and at a steady rate.